Welcome to Fenius again. From this video, we are starting lecture number 2, Best Practices in Excel of the Financial Modeling and Valuation course. Lecture number 2 is based on various parts. This is the first part of lecture number 2. So in today's video lecture, we'll discuss some techniques for organizing and handling data, such as text to columns tool, data validation, data filter, dynamic names, and methods for navigation through financial model. These best practices will improve your work quality and enhance your efficiency. But before we move forward, kindly subscribe to my channel Fenius and press the bell icon for the notification of new videos. Let's start today's discussion. In organizing and handling data, the first technique is text to column tool. It is very helpful as you might be copying raw data from PDF file into your practical life. So if you copy data from the PDF file, then the data from each row goes in one cell. Such kind of data is neither usable nor understandable. So with the help of text to column tool, we can make our data meaningful. I'll click on the data tab and select text to column box. Do remember, this tool provides us two options, that is delimited and fixed width. Delimited is suitable when a blank space, commas, dot or a tab separate the data within the cell. And the fixed width, on the other hand, is the mechanical way to divide the data into columns. In this dialog box, we need to choose the criteria which will be used to separate the data into columns. I'll check the box space. And here we have a preview of what will be the output of our modification. Click OK. See? Now let's try fixed width on the other data. As you can see over here, the data is evenly distributed, so we can easily apply the fixed width option. I'll click on the data tab, select the text to column box and click fix width and then the select point to break the data. And then select the data format and then click finish to see the output. See, our data is nicely organized into columns. Now let's discuss data filter. Data filter allows the user to filter the data according to his or her requirement. Select the cell where you want to apply the filter and then click on the data tab and select the filter option. Now you can see the drop down button with the cell. If you click on it, it will give you an option to filter the data by clicking on the checkboxes. For example, in this data, we need the data of a specific year. You can select the year and it will show you the data of that specific year. And then by clicking on select all, we can have our whole data available. Now let's assume some rows are colored in yellow due to some specific purpose. So now if you want to check the details of highlighted data, click on the drop down button and select filter by color. Press the yellow rectangle and only the highlighted cells of the table will be displayed. Generally, if the table contains different color, you can see all of them here. Alternatively, you could filter by no fill, which would mean you would see all the cells of the table that have no color applied to them. Over here, you can also apply the data sorting option. We will discuss data sorting later. Now we'll try to learn data validation. If you see over here, we have the data table which has one blank column, region. Let's suppose that we know that there are four possible values for the field in this range. We might want to create a drop-down menu that would allow us to select the region category for each row. The way to do that is data validation. First of all, we have to select the range of cell for which we would like to create a drop-down menu. Once we have done that, we can go to data and click on the data validation box. In the first window which opens, we can select as validation criteria list and indicate which are the values in our list. Once we have done that, our drop-down menu is ready and we can select the correct entries for each of the rows. Kindly note that if we try to type within these cells, we'll receive an error message. Error message can be switched off by going to the data validation menu, clicking the error alert tab and unclicking the first checkbox. Once it is done, even if we type over the cells of the range something different, we'll not receive an error message. Now I'll teach you how to navigate through financial model. In financial model, we have formulas and calculations spanning across various worksheets. So it is difficult to find which formula and calculation are linked with which sheet. This is certainly the case if you don't know about the clockwise and then use the F5 technique to implement it. First, you have to double click on a formula and Excel will take you to the first of the formula's input. Kindly note that if this does not happen to your computer, then you have to adjust your Excel option. For that, go to File option and then select the Advanced tab. Here, simply unclick the Allow Editing directly in Cell option. Now, if you double click on the specific formula, it will take you to the formula input, and then if you press F5, it will take you back to the cell where we have the original formula. See, isn't it interesting? Do remember, this technique is very important for all advanced users working on models containing multi-layered calculations across several sheets. Normally, a good model is used for more than one company or for more than one period. So now we'll learn how to assign dynamic names to cells in a financial model. By dynamically linking the cells where we introduce text in the model, such as the company's name, the financial period or the currency, etc., to an input page. We will allow ourselves to modify only once when some of the parameters change. Let me teach you how it is done. In this sheet here, we have a company name and a cell which reads income statement. Now we can click the company name to the cell income statement in the following way. Type equals to in front of the income statement and put quotation marks around it. In this way, we are creating a text formula. Now let's use the AND function and link to Unilever Pakistan, that is the name of the company. The formula produced the following result. If we change the name within the source cell to HBL Limited, it will automatically update the formula. See, this is how we create dynamic names in our financial models, which make them more flexible for future modification. That's it from my side. If you have any query, write in the comment section and I'll try to answer your query. Don't forget to like and share this video with others. Till the next video, take care. Bye.